I'm delighted to welcome now in the studio former Labour TD, now Fianna Fáil TD, as of lunchtime today, Colm Keaveney. Sorry. Deputy Keaveney, welcome to the programme.
George, it's a pleasure as usual.
Politics doesn't have very high rep in this country, but today strikes me and many other people as extraordinarily opportunistic. You move into Fianna Fáil, I put to you, because simply you have a better chance of getting elected in Galway East,
George,
than you have as an independent.
I don't. I'm one of those deputies that doesn't lose sleep at night about the next general election.
Deputy, come on. Like, you're a socialist.
I'm a social democrat. I'm a social democrat, which is there is a distinction.
You said to me, yes, you know, the Labour Party, you talked about the Labour Party for over 100 years, the oldest political party in this country. You talked about your commitment to their policies, even though you voted against them in the election. And you go now to a party that brought the country to its knees, a party that has three former ministers in its ranks, yeah, in Dáilín, who sat through this. And you're suggesting that overnight they've had a Pauline conversion.
No,
how do you explain that to people?
Can I just maybe address that in the latter end of my response? The first driver in my decision is a decision made based on policy, and over the course of the last 12 months I have actually had identified with emerging policies from Fianna Fáil that were consistent with my own, particularly in the area of mental health, intellectual disability.
Let's talk about pulverised Tuam. Yeah. Are you seriously saying that Tuam is pulverised by the economic actions of this government over the last 2 years or so, rather than the 13 years previous of Fianna Fáil? Is that what you're seriously...
George, can I tell you, I was elected for tomorrow. I can't undo that decisions of the past. Let's be very clear. I raised three children. I want to ensure that they have a future in this country, and I will make any sacrifice. I will drive any length to ensure that our young people have a future in this country. I am satisfied. I am absolutely satisfied from what I can establish that this is a party that has accepted and apologised for its role in any decisions in the context of the type of politics in the past.
Look, if this could be... because you're a young man, like, you don't remember what a Fianna Fáil Taoiseach like Jack Lynch did to the economy. Local government to this day is destroyed by the actions of a rank grab for power by Jack Lynch. You're suggesting to the people of Ireland that you believe, and it's your beliefs that count, not mine, that you believe this leopard has changed its spots now, not like the previous 70 years.
Okay.
Can
I analyse something with you? The three budgets prior to the change of government in 2011 have independently been verified as progressive budgets relative to people's capacity to burden their capacity to share and contribute with the difficulties in the economy. Under this government, the last three budgets have independently been verified as unfair. That's not even a question for debate or subjectivity between you or I, George. I can't undo the decisions of the past, okay? But what you are suggesting, however, that Ireland is unique in this situation. You cannot honestly impose a caricature on a political party. Next, you will be suggesting the Fianna Fáil were responsible for Italy, Portugal, Cyprus, and so on. Yes, we had unique problems in this country. Yes, we had the construction and property industry. But yes, the only political party, as far as I am concerned, that has learned is Fianna Fáil.
I have to say, I did hear this before. I heard a former say it was all Lehman Brothers' fault and not Fianna Fáil's. Come on. Deputy, like, if I thought this was motivated by what you're suggesting to me, sheer honest belief that, like, I can't understand that a man who swore allegiance to a party of 100 years that is, you know, I think appropriating left wing or right wing, but like, at no time, at any time in their respective histories have Labour and Fianna Fáil been close, despite even being in coalition.
Let's be very
this
clear.
Is a sea let's change be very by you no, of no, extraordinary
let's be very
move.
Clear. Let's be very clear. The only political infrastructure culture that I can associate with myself at this very moment, and I will continue to associate myself with, is the one that provides me with a fairer approach. Over the course of the last 2 years, it is patently clear that Fianna Fáil have identified the unfairness in the economy with respect to the disproportionate shouldering that many people in society have to carry with respect to the public service adjustments. Can I just go back to the issue of fairness? The last three budgets were clearly, objectively and independently identified as unfair.
Well, they probably were. I don't care. Like,
but I do,
no,
George.
But
I do
you
care.
Don't really.
I do care because
don't.
No, I, George.
No, you don't no, care. No, you don't care. This is opportunism, the likes of which I haven't seen in 11 years in the radio.
Okay,
you're only
George,
doing this for one reason, and one reason alone, I put it to you. You want to get elected in Galway East, and the best way of doing it is by Fianna Fáil.
If I wanted to get elected, and if you accuse me of the type of opportunism that you accuse me of, I would have joined Fianna Fáil at a very much younger age in that constituency where you believe that it is the party of opportunism. Why would I have successfully stayed with the most unpopular political party based on the values that I believed it subscribed to, the Labour Party in East Galway? Why would I have had stayed when the party was...
But you didn't stay. No, you didn't stay with them. As Richard Nixon said, if you can't stand the heat in the kitchen. As soon as the kitchen that was hot, you were off the griddle like a hot snot and you resigned. And like there are men and women of Fine Gael and Labour who probably will lose their seats. There's no question they will lose their seat in the next election because they are over the most unpopular budgetary measures in years, but they are loyal to their parties.
But George, you talk about a cynicism in Irish politics. You've also analysed one of the chief contributors to that cynicism. You cannot stand in front of the Irish people and say one thing in opposition, give commitments prior to the election that you would recover the economy but not at the cost of the people in society who were not responsible. You cannot do that and not significantly contribute to the cynicism that exists. If you accuse me of cynicism or my actions pale into insignificance relative to the promises that were made prior to the last general election, which were broken.
All right, one thing we know about opposition, whether it's Fianna Fáil, Labour or anybody, it's a cinch in opposition. Like, opposition parties practice the politics of opposition. So just oppose for the sake of oppose. Then they get into government and they discover what the real world is like. What you're listening to now is the politics of opposition. Me all Martin can promise anything he likes because he doesn't have to stand over it. The real test will be if they ever again Fianna Fáil get into power, will they stand over the promises they make? And tradition tells us that they won't. Let's go back to Colm Keaveney. There had to be a point in your life where you said to me, I decided to join a political party, and it wasn't a popular party or whatever. You were president of the Union Students in Ireland and so on. You were an activist from a very early age, you know, when I thought kicking footballs was my... So therefore, to make a commitment to public service remains the highest calling there is. But because it's the highest calling to public service, it demands certain standards of the people who call, the people who say, I serve. And like you must have said at that point, the Labour Party represents my ideals. You must have said that.
But the ideals that were committed prior to the last general election were conceded. It was carte blanche. They were conceded in their entirety. The decisions that were made, particularly over the budgets of 2013 and 2014, completely were at odds with the policy commitments that were offered by that political party prior to the last general election.
I'm not going to embarrass you by playing truckload of clips because you remember them yourself, where you talked about Fianna Fáil, corruption, all that sort of stuff. Now, what you are not telling me, you're listening to the people who are listening, that these guys have changed. These are now virgin pure in Fianna Fáil. Never again will we see them fill semi-state boards with their appointees. We see even now the central remedial clinic. We see Fianna Fáil hats tax paid over above to the CEOs. Now, you're saying this will never happen again. The good guys are back in the white hats. Hopalong Cassidy's going to ride into town and it's going to be a different ballgame. Is that what you're trying to tell us?
Politics is a human endeavour. Please, George, please. You're a very civil person. I respect your analysis. You're just going to have to respect mine.
Well, okay. You see, I don't. I mean, I have to honestly say that I don't.
I see your disappointment.
I do. I see your disappointment. I do. Because you're the next generation. It's not Pat Rabbit, Bertie Quinn, Micheál Martin, Enda Kenny, Richard Bruton. It is people like you
George,
who are...
I don't believe in independence. I do not believe that the independent grouping within the Dáil can achieve what I need to achieve for my constituency.
I agree.
I wake up every morning with a conviction to try and address the representation.
I like it.
But George, you're just going to have to take in good faith. Politics is a human endeavour. Yes, mistakes were made in the past, but I was elected for tomorrow. My determination is to influence policy to have better outcomes for your listeners
all right,
tomorrow.
Okay. Now, Chris Andrews left Fianna Fáil, went to Sinn Féin because he said Fianna Fáil weren't radical enough. So where does that put Labour? I mean, that essentially puts Labour on the most conservative end of the spectrum. Is that where they are?
I'm not here to answer for Labour. I have a very strong sense that an arrangement has been made in government where Labour have abdicated their role in the economy to Fine Gael in exchange for some unforeseen arrangements, maybe in the secular liberal agenda. I'm not there to analyse that. But what I'm not satisfied is that the Labour Party clearly have not had the type of influence that I expected on the economy that would have provided for fairness.
I respect that. I mean, I respected you when you resigned because I can understand somebody saying, I can't live with this anymore. Tommy Bruin, Roisin Shortall, many others who said, we cannot carry the whip for this. Yeah. But they didn't join Fianna Fáil. They didn't join Bertie and Jack Lynch and Cowan and the history that has brought this country to the state.
George,
every single one of your constituents is paying for Fianna Fáil.